Hi everybody, how are y'all doing? I'm in a bit of a rush right now. Well, I'm not exactly in a rush per se, but I'm out on my dash. I'm door dashing right now. I've been active for 15 minutes, and I just got my first couple of orders. They assigned me one that was like $6 going like a mile from inside the mall. And then as I'm in there, I got assigned a second one. Completely forgot to screenshot it, so I can't even show that one, but it was like $9 for a couple extra miles or something like that. So I picked that up too. But by the time I was assigned that one, I was already on my way out of the mall, and like, it's a decent walk to the food court. So I just had to turn back around, go to the food court, grab it, and then work my way back out here. So like I said, I've been active 15 minutes. I received my first order 15 minutes ago. It's just taken me this long just to get them, but by the time I'm done with these two, I should have like at least 15 bucks. So I'm hoping I finish it before the 45 minute mark, which I absolutely should. Now, I know that yesterday I said I was gonna be dashing all day, and that was originally my intention. It was still my intention when I woke up this morning. However, it didn't end up happening because for whatever reason, a week ago when I set my schedule for today, past me decided to set it as 6 a.m. until midnight. I woke up at 7 a.m. I set alarms for 6, but I slept through them. Woke up at 7, and of course my dash had been ended because I didn't sign in, so that means my entire dash for the whole day was gone. So I ended up just having to scramble to get what I could, and I was able to pick up 5:30 till 8, and then I'm hoping that it's going to be busy enough after that that I can pick up something else, because they've got peak pay on tonight from 9:30, so I'm guessing that they're anticipating it being busy. It is a Friday night, so that would make sense. So here's hoping. My only goal for tonight, because I got out so late, is to make $100. So let's see how we do. Well, here's what that second one I got assigned ended up looking like. Pretty damn good, I gotta say. And then I just got assigned this one immediately after dropping it off. So we're off to a pretty good start by now. Once I'm done with this one, I'll have almost $26. I knocked that one out super quick, about 10 minutes or so. And of course, it made my car smell like fish. So that's just fantastic. And yeah, I'm sitting at $25.59 in 50 minutes. Definitely off to a good start. Okay, I just took a stack order that was pretty bad. It was 7 miles, but this is what it ended up being right here. Completely forgot to screenshot it when I took the order, but I'm up to 35.28 in just about an hour and a half. I'm a little far away from hotspots, but I'm still in my zone, which I'm happy about. So far, so good. Again, my goal tonight is $100, and it's 7:20. I'm already at 35. I think I can make the other 65 before midnight. Okay, drove back into my zone and got this order from Panera Bread. Really decent. And I'm gonna have it done in about 6 minutes according to my map, so $7 in 6 minutes, I'll take it. I just took another pretty damn terrible stack order that I once again forgot to take a screenshot of. I'm gonna get better at this, but it came out to this. No tip on the Chick-fil-A order, that's to be expected. It was about 8 miles. It took me about 25 minutes, I think, to complete, if not more. So I'm at just under $50 in just under 2.5 hours. Right on track, but I'm pretty far away from any hotspots right now, so it's gonna take a little bit to get back anywhere where I'm gonna get some orders. Next up, we're stopping off at Red Tacos. I've delivered from here once or twice before, I think. $8 for 7.3 miles is pretty goddamn terrible, I can't lie, but it is taking me kind of back towards where I wanna be, so that's fine. And I also took it because it was 8:29 and my dash was only scheduled until 8:30. I guess it got extended by like a half hour. So I did that because it would extend my dash a little further. But after this one, my dash is going to end and I just have to hope that I can jump back in for a few hours. Okay, completed that one and I've got 57:28 in just about 3 hours. Exactly 3 hours, actually. And as I kind of expected, I'm not able to sign back in to continue dashing right now. It's completely gray. I'm at a 40% acceptance rate, so even after taking all of those stack orders, it's only gone up by 2%. I am still gonna stay out, though. I'm in an apartment complex right now. This is where I ended up doing my final delivery to. I'm gonna take a quick break, eat some of the food that I have with me, and then I'll start heading back towards where I wanna be in the zone, and hopefully will actually be able to sign back in. Because from 9:30 p.m. tonight until, like, 11:30? Yeah, so for that 2 hours, there's $3 peak pay. Which is exactly why it's not busy right now, because everybody's out for that peak pay. I'm just kind of bummed because I was scheduled for the entire day, and I just messed up this morning. Okay, I managed to get back signed in at 9:15 p.m., or 9 p.m., sorry. 9:15, and I've just picked up my next order from this little place called El Mason. I'm gonna get all of the Mexican restaurant names wrong because I'm the worst. But two orders going that far. So, really not bad at all for my first one back, and this is without peak pay. The peak pay doesn't kick in for another 15 minutes. I only got myself scheduled for another hour, but if I can knock this one out, and then maybe get one more in, then I'm gonna get at least 30 minutes of peak pay. All right, got it done pretty quickly, and just got my next one. It's 9:37, so only got about 20-something minutes left of the peak pay. Or of my shift, I should say, not of the peak pay. But if it keeps being busy, I'm hoping that I can once again, you know, come back out once the shift does end, but we'll see. And also, it started snowing pretty heavily. Great. I was able to reschedule myself. I'm now scheduled till 11:30. I just got this one from Panda Express. It's not fantastic, especially given there's $3 peak pay. But I'm taking it anyway because I want to get my acceptance rating up, and it's still, I think, more dollars than miles, right? I forget what it was, but it's fine. I'll take it. We'll survive. I just got this absolute banger of an order from Wendy's. I had to drive a good bit to get back to where there were any kind of orders going on, but $8.50 is it for like 2 miles? Something like that? It's insane. That's the best order I've had all night. The only problem with this Wendy's is its address is wrong. So I know where it is, luckily, but the Dasher map is telling me to go like 15 minutes south of here, which is not where it is. So I'm not gonna be doing that, DoorDash. I am also not gonna be in focus. Hey, I'm just here for a DoorDash for Carter. Okay. Interrupt me before I've even finished saying what I'm saying, and also take 3 minutes to even come to the speaker. Excellent. If you didn't catch that, all I said was, hey, I'm just, and I immediately got hit with, I don't have any DoorDash, sorry. You should have. Your system's on, you accepted the order. Now I get to call support. Well, I got through to support relatively quickly, and they've issued half pay, so there's that. What's that going to be, like $4.25, something like that? Oh, six. So that was a $12 order. Look at that, $6 reimbursement right there. Camera's having some trouble. $6, which means it was a $12 order. It had a hidden tip on there. Well, that's a goddamn bummer. I decided to park up outside Dash Mart so I wasn't just wasting time driving around, wasting gas, because I know this place is open until like 3 a.m., and got a banger stack order. And I know these guys aren't gonna be like, oh, we're not taking any orders, because it's bloody DoorDash's store. Okay, peak pay is over. That last one took me a little north out of my zone, so I've just taken this White Castle order. It's not fantastic, but it is going back into my zone, which is the main reason that I took it. So let's get this done. I've just picked it up. It's gonna take about 10 minutes. Okay, I completed the White Castle one, and then it immediately was like, you want to do this McDonald's one that's $2 for 5.3 miles? Obviously, no, I don't, but if I decline it, my acceptance rating is going to go down. It didn't even give me a chance to pause my dash. I'm just going to wait it out, and I'm going to hope that that doesn't count as a decline. Because if I decline it, I'll go down to 43%, so I'm just going to wait out the timer. Let's see. Oh my god, it immediately offered me one from Taco Bell. Two orders. I can't decline that too, can I? Oh, I can. I guess I did go down to 43, but I can decline this one and it doesn't count. Ah! Okay, I ended up taking that Taco Bell stack and I just got it done. It's 12:17. Not sure how much money I'm at right now, but whew, I'm tired. I'm gonna start heading towards home. I am able to dash now, again, until 1 a.m., so I'm gonna turn it on. If I get anything, I'll talk about it when I get home, but for now, I'm gonna stop filming every order, but I'm tired. I'm gonna start heading towards home. Okay, I ended up taking this one, and I ended up taking this one, and then I came home. because that last one actually was being delivered 2 minutes down the around the corner from where we live. So that was pretty good. Final totals for the night: $133.53 in 6 hours and 45 minutes, which is an average of $19.78 per hour. That is the best hourly that I've had so far this year. And I hope it just keeps getting better. It's also the first Friday I think I've worked this year, so it's not really surprising, but hey, I made good money tonight. I've already cashed it out. I've paid off a couple of things, so I'm feeling pretty good about that. I'm going to be going out again tomorrow, but I don't know what time yet. I know I have a schedule already, but I've got some stuff to work on, so we'll see. Thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for tomorrow, and I'll see you guys then.